All right, straight ahead, we'll get to this lightweight bout between Nate Diaz and Mark Giacchese. So, Joe, as this fighter makes his way to the octagon, we have to start with the kicking technique. It's excellent. Doesn't telegraph anything. Gets his foot to the target as quickly as any fighter on this UFC roster. More often than not, guys don't even see it coming. He attacks that lead leg beautifully. Opponent certainly is wary of those lightning-fast kicks coming in here tonight.
This guy has ridiculous hand speed. His opponent is going to need to keep his chin tucked and his hands up high.
Proudly repping the 209 in Stockton, California. Here is the longtime UFC welterweight and lightweight staple, Nate Diaz. It's hard to imagine any fight that Nate Diaz is involved in not being pleasing to the masses. Of course, no bigger moment for him than shocking the world with a win over Conor McGregor at UFC 196.
Nate Diaz, like his brother Nick, has devastating cardio, utilizes a long reach, outstanding, accurate boxing, and a world-class Brazilian jiu-jitsu game to go with it.
And now our tale of the tape for this lightweight fight. Diaz is 8 years his senior. He will have a 3-inch reach advantage. All right, now for the official introductions, we go to the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Mario Yamasaki. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! A round in the UFC lightweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 12 wins, 3 losses. He stands 5 feet 10 inches tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Doncaster, England, Mark the Crusher Giacchese. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 20 wins, 11 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 155 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, USA, ladies and gentlemen, an Ultimate Fighter season winner, Nate Diaz!
All right, I gave instructions to you guys in the locker room. I want you guys to follow my orders at all times. Defend yourself at all times. Touch gloves.
This is a fight that we have been looking forward to for a long time and is about to take place right now. I'm very excited.
Here you go. First one, you ready? Are you ready?
All right, we are underway here at the home of the UFC, the T-Mobile Arena here in Las Vegas. Effective punch there by Giacchese. The 1-2 punch is true. Flipped him with the jab. Right hand upstairs. Oh, Giacchese gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line. He blocks the punch. Oh, strong punch there by Diaz. Move that up.
Beautiful shot for him. Big straight punch.
Lands a strike there. Well, he absorbs a kick to the head here, left it wide open. He's got to not move into that power shot. Let's see if he can adjust. Nice body kick there.
He's doing a great job of being unpredictable and mixing things up here. Oh, tries a flying knee.
Oh, nice punch there by Diaz.
They're going after it quick here.
Diaz gets caught with that punch.
That one hurt.
Oh, nice jab by Diaz. Just misses with a left hook there. Oh, he found the target there. That'll work. Well, he continues to find his timing here. Series of strikes, they all land.
Nice right hook to the head. Good 1-2 by Nate. Big power
so
hook.
With that hook, Joe. Oh, right hook attempt, no good. Oh! Under 3 minutes now to go on the round.
Good shot.
Both fighters exchange in the pocket here.
Really missed with that right hand.
Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Jacaso. Oh, and he tags him with the straight hand there. Beautifully done by Diaz.
Knees right here. He's got to get those knees to the body. Lands one. Got the over-under here. He's got double underhooks here.
Jacaso's lower jaw is extremely swollen now.
And he pummels out of it.
3 minutes have elapsed here in round one. And he lands a kick to the leg now. Pretty good work on the feet tonight by Jacaso. Ooh, tagged him with the uppercut. Well, if you're going to leave your body that wide open, you're going to pay the price, and he certainly did there as his opponent lands flush to the midsection. Just out of range with that right hand. Oh, nice jab to the head there by Diaz. Beautiful combination of punches to the head. He gets tagged again.
Nice front kick.
Oh, Jacaso gets caught with that punch. Just missed with the left there.
And the chance of Diaz ring through the crowd.
Trying to double up on that jab. Trying to find a home for that right hand. Less than a minute to go in the round. Oh, a nice inside leg kick landed there by Jacaso. Effective punch there by Diaz. 45 seconds remain in the round.
Yeah, it's freak. It's like he's cheating. You know, it's like he's got rocks in his gloves.
Diaz gets caught with that punch. Yeah, missed on that one, Joe. Oh!
Big left hand!
Ooh, uppercut, man.
This is crazy! Oh, my goodness!
He's got him hurt here. Oh, big right hand there!
And there's a nice jab.
And now he lands a combination. And now starting to snap off that jab.
Vicious, vicious punch combinations here. Hurt him with that right.
Second round, straight ahead.
Hold on, stop, stop, stop.
Beautiful strike here, lands on target. Here's a nasty head kick that lands. Here's a powerful head kick that lands. Very impressive striking going on in that round.
Brittany Palmer doing her thing as usual.
Here we go, second round, you ready? You ready?
All right, let's get to round two.
Now, starting off this round, he might still be hurt. He's going to want to look to be defensive and move and avoid getting hit and try to recover. Oh, strong inside leg kick. Really, he might have hurt his knee there. Oh! He got hurt very, very badly.
And there he swung with a haymaker.
He hurt him with that hook.
How about that shin?
Hurt him with that uppercut.
What a fight we got going on here.
Oh, very nice.
Big left.
Oh, that head kick landed. Hard straight punch.
Try to establish that jab.
He's tagging him here.
Slips the punch.
That one hurt.
Nice punch by Diaz. Oh, yeah, looks a little wobbly on his feet. Man, has his chin been tested early.
Each other out.
Inside control.
And back to his feet.
Orthodox for much of the fight. He's going southpaw here, Joe. Jacacy's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Diaz gets caught with that punch. Leg kick. The combinations are flowing. So a much different approach from him here in round two. Took him a while to find the range, get in his striking rhythm. He has found it here, and as a result, has really picked up the pace in round two.
Eats a nice right hand.
Throwing that jab.
Whoa! This could be it right here.
Oh, he might be out.
And he's looking for that left.
Well, he's playing with fire here, Joe. He continues to be vulnerable to that jab by almost leaning into it right into his opponent's range. Got to find a way to move those feet and ultimately get that head off of the center line. Straight punch there again. Been there all night. Oh, and he connects once again. There is no denying he is targeting that cup.
Just tagged him with the right hand there.
Punch is blocked. Getting the hands going here early. Well, he lands another jab, really employing the jab effectively here.
Check that kick.
Oh, strong hook to the head there by Jacace.
He lands a clean combination.
90 seconds now to go in this one. Oh, he got everything behind that kick.
Body kick
looked like it did stun him a little bit.
He's rocked.
He's in a lot of trouble.
Oh!
Here he's in mission control. It looks like he's got a submission locked up. Now he throws his leg over the shoulder. He's got that omoplata locked up tight.
He might get it here. Look at this.
He may have to tap any second now. This omoplata is getting very tight. He got it. He got it.
Nicely done.
Round was almost over, but he sunk in the submission and got the victory.
Right, I mean, how do you not admire the focus of this young fighter? You could tell he was looking for that submission much earlier in the round, but he didn't want to rush it. He stayed patient, let the setup do its thing, and ultimately the submission materializes organically late in the round. High-level stuff out of that young fighter here tonight.
And here it is again, absolutely perfectly executed.
And one more time, nice technique here on this submission.
So there he is, your winner by submission tonight, and that is how you put the rest of the division on notice. A huge result for him here tonight. All right, the official decision is in. It resides with Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Mario Yamasaki has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 21 seconds of round number 2. Declaring the winner by submission due to an omoplata, Nate Diaz!
All right, so another win for the 209. Congratulations to Nate Diaz and Team Caesar Gracie. And this is the type of performance that really endeared Nate Diaz to the MMA masses and what has made him one of the biggest superstars in mixed martial arts history. He put all the skills together tonight. The fight IQ was on display. Big, big moment in a career full of them for Nate Diaz here tonight.
Shadows, you conjure with your purse. Yeah, you're walking in.